Welcome back to Let's Play Cyberpunk 2077 Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, heading for the next Cyberpsycho thing, which is an undiscovered Cyberpsycho. Very rainy. I gotta make so much noise when I walk. Is these boots? These things are still that noisy? Jeez. What the pants are. It's a very Blade Runner-esque evening. I don't know, what time is it? Oh, that's cool. Oh, I just noticed a little icon that changes in over here. Oh yeah, it is the evening. It's almost 8. Next Cyberpsycho is not too far at all.
V.
Hello.
A few Zeta Tech corporals walked into an auto shop.
Sounds like a joke.
Punchline. None came back out.
Huh.
Apparently, it's a family business that's fallen on hard times. My hunch is the owners finally snapped, and you know I got a nose for this stuff.
Okay. Got noises coming from an auto shop. Sounded like a series of explosions. My take, either the roof collapsed or someone's gone Cyberpsycho. I'm betting on the latter. Look at that. Let's disarm that. I doubt that'll work. Dead corpo. Unresponsive, no pulse. Death caused by severe concussion, most likely from an IED. I thought that would stop once my thing wore out. My distraction. Or attempted distraction, anyway. The other end of that. Dumpster. Front toward enemy. I see someone over there. Gaston Phillips? Thank you. He still hasn't located me. Now he has. I don't want to arm it and kill him. We need him alive. There you are. I didn't lose him. Couldn't get to him. Whoops. I want to disarm that. And that. Ah! Where are you? Can't target. Here we go. Yo. Yeah, I can't. Yeah. Whoops. Whoa. Not fair. I had 1 point. I had 1 hit point left. Letter of the law. Wow. And I wasn't that low when he killed me. Now that's off, right? Oh no. Now it is. That one. Trying to get that one. Not that one. That one. That's off? Thank you. Looks like it's on to me. How'd you see me through that? Oh, he's over there. Oh. Ouch. Just stick your head out there. Gotcha. M251 Ajax. Something saying stop, don't do it. Oh, it doesn't. It opened automatically. I didn't have to hit Z to read it. That's weird. Let this be a warning to anyone thinking about buying this shop. Don't be fooled by the fantastic location or top shelf equipment, because guess what? None of it will be yours, even after you sign whatever agreement the corp gives you. What, you surprised? Well, so was I. I shouldn't have been, though. It was right there in front of my eyes, in black and white. If anyone wastes my time reading some complicated agreement with more twists than that Apple novel by a certain Virginia. I also didn't bother doing my research, or else I would have found out the shop changed hands 3 times already this year, and the previous owners disappear without a trace, except their debts, that is. All I can say is, I've dealt with my fair share of gangs looking for protection money or a one-time heist, but nobody, I mean nobody, has ever screwed me over quite like the suits at Zetatech. So I've only got one answer for them. A wrench to the face and a vice for their fingers. That's one hell of an answer. Alright, now before I get killed by a landmine... That was armed. And then we've got one over here. Oops. I'm having trouble getting that. Same concussion, i.e. knee. Okay. Same. Nothing. Oh, hello. Can't get in there anyway. Wait. Alright, I'll check that out in a bit. Foreclosure notice number 23HT/15 and a better Arasaka cap. I keep upgrading my Arasaka caps. 36.49 euros as well. Due to the failure to uphold the terms of agreement number UPL/12064 and failure to respond to letter of demand for outstanding payment number 11055. Hopefully this one person didn't have that many letters of demands for outstanding payment. In accordance with paragraph 628 of the aforementioned agreement, the real property shall become the property of Zetatech within 2 days of receipt of this document. This decision is not subject to appeal. How about subject to death? Is it subject to death? They really didn't want someone coming in from this way. They just don't want someone coming in this way. Which they have to worry about. It's kind of hard to get in this way. Busy, huh? That's disappointing. I thought I could get in there. I looked at you, right? Even though they're all the same, we have to look at all of them. Computer. License? What license? Hey, I got a cease and desist from Zetatech. They say I'm using that lift in my shop without a license. What is this? I bought the whole shop from them, spent my life savings on it. They want to get me again because of some license? Could you check and see if they made a mistake somewhere? And what sort of eddies are we talking about here? So that was from Gaston Phillips to Laurent, or Laurent Lawless. From Laurent? Gaston, I contacted Zetatech on your behalf, and it does seem that the equipment in the shop was not included in the deed. You bought the shop building, four walls, the floor, and ceiling. That's it. I asked about the price of the tech, and they're unable to give an estimate because the shop in which it's located has been bought out. From Gaston. But I'm the one who bought it out. Think I would know. So what do we do now? Laurent says... Now they have to buy it back from you, and since prices have fallen in the area, you stand to lose a fair amount. But then we have priority to buy it back, and if we want to speed up the process, we could give them an offer right now to purchase the shop and equipment along with the loan approval for whatever is needed to cover the difference. That's the good news. Bad news is the equipment costs about double the shop itself. Gaston says, fine, I don't know. Go ahead and file that loan application so I don't lose my chance. Then I'll think it over some more. Besides, what's a shop without equipment? I can't even work without it. From Laurent. All right, Gaston, it's all ready. I just need your signature and you can reopen. Great, thanks for your help. It's hard to deal with this all by myself. I'm going back to work, finally. The animals. And nano gel scam alert. Alright, message Regina. Another cyberpsycho case concluded. Auto shop owner was on a rampage, but I managed to put him to sleep. The way corps here gobble up small businesses, it's almost painful to watch. Before they even clock what's happening, the owners are locked out of their own premises and slapped with a colossal debt. Then they bust their asses for the corp from morning to midnight to make ends meet. Looks like this one preferred to take his own life than give up the one place that was his. See how quickly the American dream can turn into the American nightmare? Indeed I do. Indeed I do see that. Always looking here to make sure it's no longer like new. All right, job complete. Now where should we go? I'm not buying a vehicle. All right, I got. So I'm using a Biotech Z Mark 1. Well, what was that all about? I think we just atom bomb just fell or something. I don't think what I have is any better. But I'll visit the Ripper Doc. Maybe he has something better himself. He's up, though. Sparks going on up here. Doc Ryder?
Look, I'm waiting for a friend.
So are we all. Talk to her. Guess I'll just come back here.
So, as I was saying,
mind taking a look at my chrome?
Mind taking a look at my chrome?
Sure. Make yourself comfortable.
So he doesn't have implants. Oh, I require stuff here. Two slots. Oh, nice. 16,000. Raven Micro Cyber Mark III. Some call these decks battleships. When it comes to system security and fortified anti-theft protocols, it's a foolproof piece of machinery. I can see that. Oh, wow. I don't even have... Oh, yeah, I have money for that. It's 35,000. 11 base RAM, 8 buffer size, 6 slots. Wow. A CyberDeck series used by the best Netwatch agents and a frightening beast in terms of its offensive capabilities. It's best if Netwatch didn't catch you using this. Now, just in case I mess something up. Alright. 5, 5, and 3. So going from 11, 8, and 6. Legendary, iconic. Wow. Is it vendor items? No, okay. Mechatronic core. I own all this stuff. I need better body scores for this stuff. 10 body, 8 body. Smart Link. Smart Targeting Module. So yeah, he really doesn't have any. Why don't you have any implants?
You never got yourself chipped?
Oh, he doesn't have...
Like having a dentist with no teeth, isn't it?
On himself.
I have good rep. You won't hear any complaint about me.
I thought he meant he wasn't selling any. He's still selling a few, not that many, but... Why, your job would be easier with the Kuroshi implant.
Let's make
why?
This quick.
Job would be a lot easier with some zoom-capable Kuroshi optics.
I'm sure it would. Until the day this planet gets hit by a massive solar flare.
That's kind
of... I'm talking about a geomagnetic storm that wipes out all live circuit systems, implants included. So why would I get Kuroshi if sooner or later I just go blind?
So why'd you become a Ripper Doc?
You're so paranoid. Why are you chipping other people with chrome?
I like the job. Besides, nobody wants to hear the truth anyway.
All right, well, thanks. How you doing?
Well, that's a first.
Great. Oops, sorry.
So, as I was saying...
I gotta see someone I can use this stuff on. I don't even necessarily need to use it on any of them. Just want to see what comes up and is available. Caliente. Man, we're the unsavory types. There's all over the place every other time. Man, it makes so much noise. Walking, running. I think I've been over here. Killed all the people inside. Alright, I'm getting bored with the bad guys. Someone around here. Hostage taking. Bad guys. I know they're around somewhere, it's just where. Can't find a bad guy to save my life.
Did you know last gen Cyberman damaged your roof from the center? Make sure your implant is always the latest mod on the
screen. Jeez, all the bad guys are sleeping. They should be ashamed of themselves. Here we go. So I can't do anything. Do I not have this configured right or something? Oh, I have to put the mods in. Contagion. Cyberware malfunction. Sonic shock. Ooh. Cool. I can get more. I don't know if he was selling mods. I didn't see anything like that. That's why I couldn't do it with anybody. I should be able to aim at anybody now. Okay, maybe not. Huh. I can't do anything. There's gotta be a trick to it. Sonic shock. So I thought I put that on there. Wow. I'm not sure what's going on, guys. Can't use this? It was too high for my level. It wouldn't have let me install it. Equipped. Okay, I'm not sure what's going on here. I've gone back to the Ripper dock. Had him put the old one back on. Of course, I installed the mods back into it. Nothing's working. It's just... That's not what I want. Beat cop. I can't do anything. I'm scanning and I can't do anything here. So, I guess some bug? Because everything was working fine until I switched decks. And yes, I have mods in here. And I went back and used the other ones. Had the dock switched to the other ones, switched over the mods into there. Still, nothing. So I'm not sure. I guess next episode. Hopefully, I can find a save from after fighting the Cyberpsycho, but before going to the Ripper dock, and I'll go from there. And then I'll have to keep an eye on this thing, so I'll be reloading a previous save. I'll have to keep an eye on this and try again in a little while. Well, maybe I can just... Maybe it's just some random thing. Maybe I can restore a save and put that in. Put that... Yeah, I gotta mess around with that. But in any case, if I restore a previous save, it should work again. In any case. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. I'm trying to figure this out. And always, seek adventure.